Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Father Bryton Ward, the rector of the parish of St. John's, North Eleuthera, Harbour Island, and we thank you for tuning in to our daily devotions today, October 27th. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, in Christ you have revealed your glory among the nations. Preserve the works of your mercy, that your church throughout the world may persevere with steadfast faith in the confession of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Words taken from St. Luke's Gospel, the 12th chapter, verses 54 through 56. He also said to the crowds, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you immediately say, 'It is going to rain,' and so it happens. And when you see the south wind blowing, you say, 'There will be scorching heat,' and it happens. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of earth and sky, but why do you not know how to interpret the present time?" The Gospel of Christ. Jesus draws our attention to a common issue we face as Christians, and that is complacency. I think at some point we all fall in the lull of Christianity. Not that we do not believe, but that seeing has become all too normal for us. For many of us, we know what will accompany our day. Food, although it may not be the meal of choice. Clothing, even if it means we had to switch the outfit once or twice. And communication, whether it be good conversation or continuous feud over an issue left unresolved. But for the most part, these are just some small things that we are guaranteed, or that many of us guarantee, are going to happen within our day. But in the Gospel, Jesus asks a very pointed question. But why do you not know how to interpret the present time? Hearing the question, I immediately thought of the chorus we used to sing. "This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it." I then ask us friends, who in our lives have we stopped appreciating? And what activity, by God's hand, have we taken for granted? I will ask us again. Who in our lives have we stopped appreciating? And what activity, by God's hand, are we taking for granted? Thinking on these two questions will reveal so much for us concerning how we interpret both earth and sky and are unable to interpret the present time. Time is fleeting and time is precious. I invite us all to think on the goodness of our loving God. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in your Son's name. We pray that what we have asked faithfully, we may obtain effectually through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We thank you once again for tuning in, friends, and we ask that you share this, and may these words be a blessing to both you and those you love.
Thanks with a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ.